It's AumSum time.
What if salons disappeared?
Oh no, now what will happen to my beautiful hair?
Oh, AumSum.
To buy AumSum merchandise, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, if salons disappeared, people may start to cut their own hair by watching online videos. Secondly, if salons disappeared, some people may start sporting really long hair. Thirdly, if salons disappeared, barbers or hairdressers would have to look for a new job. Fourthly, if salons disappeared, people may start coloring their own hair at home. Lastly, if salons disappeared, some people may invent innovative, futuristic ways of cutting hair. What is color blindness?
A color festival!
No, color blindness or color deficiency is a vision problem. Now, our eyes have light-sensitive cells called rods and cones.
Can I put ice cream on these cones?
Oh, you are just unbelievable. Rods are responsible for black and white vision. They do not detect color, whereas cones detect color. There are three types of cones. One cone perceives red light, another perceives green, and the third perceives blue. Together, these cones help us to see the whole spectrum of colors. Now, in some cases, when one or more types of cones do not work properly, it causes color blindness. People with such deficiency have difficulty in distinguishing between certain colors or shades. For example, in red-green color blindness, the apple tree may appear like this. Why do we have seasons?
Because of season fairies.
No. It is mainly because of our Earth's axis. Our Earth's axis is tilted at an angle of about 23.5 degrees. Hence, as the Earth revolves around the sun, sometimes the northern hemisphere points towards the sun, while sometimes the southern hemisphere. This causes seasons.
Oh man, it is too complicated.
All right, let us observe the northern hemisphere to learn more about seasons. When the northern hemisphere points towards the sun, the sun rays directly strike the northern hemisphere. Thus, the temperatures are high, resulting in summer season in that region. However, when the northern hemisphere points away from the sun rays fall slanting on it. Thus, the temperatures are low, resulting in winter season. But when the northern hemisphere is neither tilted towards nor away from the sun, the temperatures are moderate, resulting in spring and autumn season. Why do animals' eyes glow in the dark?
Because they have hidden torches.
Nah. Wait, I'll explain. Our eyes have a layer called retina, which is made up of photoreceptors. When light enters our eyes, it hits the photoreceptors. Photoreceptors detect light, thus making it possible to see. However, the light which doesn't hit the photoreceptors remains undetected.
Poor undetected light.
Now, nocturnal animals like owls need to see better during the night. Hence, their eyes have another layer below the retina called tapetum lucidum. Now, when light doesn't hit the photoreceptors, it reaches the tapetum lucidum. This layer acts like a mirror. It reflects light back onto the photoreceptors, thus giving them a second chance to detect light. Some of this reflected light also comes out of the animal's eyes, thus making it seem that its eyes are glowing. Why do we stretch in the morning?
So that we can sleep for 2 more hours.
Nah. Wait, I'll explain. When we wake up in the morning, we yawn and stretch our arms and legs. This coordinated yawning and stretching is referred to as penticillation.
I thought it is referred to as calculation.
Just listen. When we are asleep, we don't perform any activities. Hence, our heart rate becomes slow when the blood flow is decreased. Also, as many people lie in the same position for long hours, their muscles become stiff and tight. Thus, a good stretch in the morning awakens our body. It brings our heart rate back to normal, improving the blood flow to various body parts. Stretching also loosens and realigns our stiff muscles, making them more flexible and ready for the day ahead. What is earwax?
It is a wax used to make candles.
Oh, gross. Not at all. Earwax is used to lubricate and protect our ear canal, middle ear, and inner ear.
Oh, but how does it form?
Our ear canal consists of special glands. They produce an oily and waxy substance called cerumen. Cerumen moisturizes our ears. It traps dust and dead skin cells, keeping our ears clean. Besides this, cerumen also has antibacterial properties. When harmful microbes try to enter deeper into our ears, the cerumen traps and kills the microbes. These dead microbes, dust, oil, and dead skin cells together form the earwax. Topic: human eyes. What are eye boogers?
They are similar to burgers.
Ooh, gross, no. Eye boogers generally contain oil, dust, germs, etc. They are formed from the tear film on our eyes.
Does the film have any action scenes?
Oh no. The tear film mainly consists of three layers. Mucin layer, aqueous layer, and lipid or oily layer. Together, these layers moisturize our eyes. They also trap dust and germs, which are removed while blinking. When we blink, the eyelid closes, and if there is any dust or germ, it gets discarded along with some tear film through the tear duct into the nasal cavity. But while sleeping, since we don't blink, the tear film, dust, and germs get collected in the inner corners of our eyes and start to dry out, forming eye boogers. What is a cataract?
It may be a cat's nickname.
No.
Hey!
A cataract is an eye disease.
How does it form?
Wait, I'll explain. Each of our eyes consists of a transparent lens.
Is it similar to my camera lens?
Absolutely.
Huh?
Our eye lens is made up of water and protein. They are arranged in such a way that keeps the lens clear and lets light pass through it. Hence, a sharp image is formed on the retina. However, as we age, the protein begins to clump together, making the lens cloudy. This clouding of our eye's natural lens is called a cataract. In such situations, when light from an object enters our eye, the clumped protein blocks or scatters the light. As a result, a blurred image is formed on the retina, thus making it hard to see. Topic: motion sickness. Why do we get car sickness?
Because some cars are haunted.
Nah. According to a prevailing theory, car sickness occurs because of mismatched or conflicting sensory signals. In a moving car, our eyes see that the car seats are not moving, thus informing our brain that we are stationary. However, the inner ear, which detects motion, notices the turns and bumps in the road and tells our brain that we are moving, thus creating a sensory mismatch and making us car sick.
But why do we vomit?
During human evolution, when there were no vehicles, only the intake of foods containing neurotoxins made our brain receive conflicting signals. Now, the only way to remove these neurotoxins was to vomit. Hence, in the present time, when our brain receives such mismatched signals, it thinks that there is some neurotoxin in our stomach. Thus, it induces vomiting. Topic: human eyes. What are eye floaters?
They are worms.
No. Eye floaters are tiny spots or thread-like strands that drift in our field of vision. When we move our eyes and try to look at them directly, they seem to dart away.
Yeah, dude, I think they try to hide.
Nah. When light from an object enters into our eyes, it passes through the vitreous humor to form an image on the retina. Vitreous humor is a clear gel-like substance. It is 99% water and 1% collagen fibers. These collagen fibers are spread evenly throughout the vitreous humor. But sometimes, these fibers tend to come together forming clumps or strands. When we look at a clear sky or a blank page, and the clumps or strands are very close to the retina, they cast a strong shadow on the retina, making them easily detectable in the clear background, and thus, forming eye floaters.